In the last lecture, we already seen the reactions of benzene, but the addition reactions of benzene. Now today we have to learn the substitution reaction of benzene. You know that what is in the addition reaction? In addition reaction, that molecule which we add, such as hydrogen, chlorine, ozone, etc., get completely added into that benzene ring. Now in addition reaction we have seen yesterday three addition reaction: addition of hydrogen, addition of chlorine, and addition of ozone. In hydrogen, the addition of hydrogen, we obtain cyclohexane from benzene. In addition of chlorine, we obtain BHC, benzene hexachloride, which is the insecticide. And in addition of ozone, first we obtain the triozonide ring, then that breaks with the zinc dust and water, and then we obtain the glycerol into that. You see that in the last lecture. Now come to the substitution reaction. Now what is in this substitution reaction? What is the definition of substitution reaction? We are today learning the electrophilic substitution reactions. That means electrophile, which love electrons, attack on the benzene ring. And it replaces the hydrogen atom, which is already present on the every carbon of the benzene ring. One hydrogen is there. And that electrophile replaces or displacement of hydrogen by the electrophilic group. Now that electrophilic group may be any halogen, or it may be the nitro group, NO2 group, or sulfonic acid group, SO3H group, or it is the alkyl group also in the Friedel-Crafts reaction, and in it is also acyl group. Now let us see the first substitution reaction, that is the halogenation. Now what is mean by halogenation? In this reaction, hydrogen atom of the benzene is replaced by the halogen atom, such as chlorine, bromine, iodine, etc. Now let us see first chlorination. Now there are two reactions of chlorination. In first reaction, the chlorine gas reacts with benzene in the presence of iron, ferrous, in the dark, and give chlorobenzene. Into that, the hydrogen atom, you know that in all the carbon atoms of the benzene, there are the hydrogen atom. So one of the hydrogen from this carbon is replaced by one of the chlorine atom of this chlorine molecule. And this chlorine get attached here. Now that is called chlorobenzene. Now that hydrogen which is replaced, and one of the chlorine atom of these two forms the byproduct HCl. Do you understand how the reaction is there? The hydrogen of benzene, though I am not show here hydrogen, but there are hydrogen. So one of the hydrogen is replaced by chlorine atom, and there chlorine get attaches to the benzene ring, and chlorobenzene is from that hydrogen, and one of the chlorine atom remaining forms the byproduct HCl. Now in the another reaction of this chlorination, large excess of chlorine, excess means more. Now this excess of chlorine, up to 6 molecules of chlorine are required. That means 12 atoms of chlorine are required. Now when this excess of chlorine reacts with benzene in the presence of catalyst anhydrous aluminium trichloride or anhydrous aluminium chloride, what happened there? All the 6 hydrogen atoms of the benzene are replaced, and 6 chlorine atoms attaches to every carbon atom here. All 6 hydrogen get replaced, and that remaining 6 chlorine and that 6 hydrogen atom forms the 6 molecule of HCl. That is the reaction in the presence of catalyst anhydrous AlCl3. Remember that there are two reactions in chlorination. Which reaction they That is important. If they ask, what is the excess of what is the action of chlorine in the presence of aluminium chloride or hydrous aluminium chloride, then write the below reaction. And if they ask you, what is the action of chlorine in dark with EPCl3 with the Milgi, then you give the first reaction. 2 marks for every reaction. Now, next hydrogenation, that is the bromination. Now in bromination, what happened? Bromine reacts similarly with that of the chlorine. Bromine reacts similarly to that of the chlorine. Now here, the catalyst requires ferric tribromide, FeBr3 is required. Now this bromine similarly reacts as that of the chlorine. What happened? One of the hydrogen atoms of this benzene is replaced by one bromine atom, and there is formation of bromobenzene. As it is chlorobenzene, it is called as the bromobenzene. And that replaced the hydrogen, and remaining one bromine atom formed the HBr. Now very simple reaction. But iodination of benzene are not carried out or possible, because that is the reversible reaction. As the iodobenzene is formed, again reverse reaction takes place, and again we obtain the benzene. We think that the reaction is not carried there, but their reaction is carried out. Iodobenzene is formed, but in a few minutes or few seconds, again the iodobenzene changes into the benzene and iodine. So, iodination of benzene is not possible due to the reversible reaction. Now, come to the nitration. Remember students, there is always short note on these. They ask you question, write a short note on halogenation of benzene. Then you write up to this, from this. If they ask you, write a short note on nitration, then you must write down about the nitration, everything and this reaction. Now, they may be ask you in 2 mark question also, how will you obtain bromobenzene from benzene? That question is of 2 marks. But if they ask you, write a short note on halogenation of benzene, then you must write up to this, because there will be 3 marks for the short note, sometimes 4 marks also there. Now, what is happen in nitration of benzene? That is very important topic. Now, nitration introduction of the nitro group, NO2 group. Now this is the nitro group. Introduction of the nitro group into the benzene, or replacement of the hydrogen of the benzene by the nitro group, is called as the nitration of the benzene. But for nitration, nitratating mixture is required. Now what is this nitratating mixture? What is this? That is very important. Now nitratating mixture means 3H2 part of nitric acid concentrated and sulfuric acid, both must be concentrated. Now see here, this is nothing but the nitric acid, only I write in this way. Now you know the formula of nitric acid, what is that? HNO3. Now this is also HNO3. Only I write in that manner because I want to separate this nitro group. Because that nitro group get introduced into the benzene ring, then what happened? Here is hydrogen, you know that, on the benzene ring. That hydrogen and this OH, H plus OH, what is formed? Water molecule is formed. H plus OH, what formed there? Water molecule is the byproduct. And this nitro group get attaches here, and there is formation of nitrobenzene. So during nitration of benzene, in the presence of nitratating mixture, that means HNO3, concentrated nitric acid, plus concentrated sulfuric acid, H2SO4, the nitration is carried out, and we obtain the nitrobenzene and water molecule as the byproduct. Now again, the third electrophilic substitution reaction of benzene is the sulfonation of benzene. As the name suggests, there is addition of the sulfonic acid group into the benzene, introduction of the sulfonic acid group in the benzene ring. That means replacement of hydrogen of the benzene ring by the sulfonic acid group. You know the sulfonic acid group into the 14th chapter. What is the sulfonic acid group? This SO3H. This group is called as the sulfonic acid group. But this is nothing but the concentrated sulfuric acid. See here, H2SO4. Now this is nothing but concentrated H2SO4. So in the presence of sulfuric acid, fuming sulfuric acid is required there. Fuming means vapors are coming out very very concentrated. SO2 gas get bubbled into that, and that fuming sulfur H2O7, such fuming sulfuric acid is required in very high temperature, about 373 degrees. That means 100 degree centigrade. 373 Kelvin means 100 degree centigrade. Here also 100 degree centigrade for nitration, the temperature required. Remember that. Now this I separate only this SO3H and this OH and this hydrogen which is already there on the carbon atom of the benzene. H and OH form the water molecule here because there is the hydrogen that get replaced, and on that place this SO3H get attaches. Now the name of this compound which is obtained after sulfonation of benzene is called as the benzene sulfonic acid, because this is the sulfonic acid group. So the name is remember that this is nitrobenzene, that is the nitrobenzene, but this is benzene sulfonic acid. Again the next reaction of the benzene is the Friedel-Crafts alkylation. There is Friedel-Crafts acylation also, we'll see later that. Now as the name suggests, alkylation means there is the introduction of the alkyl group into the benzene ring. So introduction of the alkyl group into the benzene ring is called as the alkylation of benzene, and in acylation there may be introduction of acyl group. Now for this, now the name of the scientist, Friedel and Crafts. So the reaction gave the name, that is the Friedel-Crafts alkylation or Friedel-Crafts alkyl reactions. Now into that, one thing is very important, that is the anhydrous AlCl3 catalyst is required for this reaction. That is very important. If you do not write on arrow that AlCl3, then you only your 1 mark minimum may be there. That is, they may be cut your marks. That is the examiner. So that is very without this anhydrous AlCl3, this reaction is not carried out. That is the Friedel-Crafts reactions. So that catalyst is very important into that. Now this benzene then reacts with the alkyl halides generally, as it is the methyl chloride, but generally any alkyl halide you can take, ethyl bromide, N-propyl iodide, any you can take. There is only what is the difference here, methyl group is introduced into the benzene ring. If there is the ethyl bromide, ethyl group get introduced. If there is isopropyl iodide, isopropyl group is introduced, and that hydrogen atom which is already there in the benzene ring and this chlorine atom forms the byproduct as HCl, and this methyl group get introduced here. Now what is the product? Methyl benzene, but commonly what it called? Toluene. You know that methyl benzene is called as the, commonly commercially it is called as the toluene. Now let us see the Friedel-Crafts acylation reaction, that is the fifth reaction. Now let us see the next fifth reaction of Friedel-Crafts acylation reaction. As the name suggests, there is the introduction of acyl group, or it is also called as the acetyl group. What is that acyl or acetyl group? This CH3CO. It can be write in this way also, CH3C double bond O. This and this is same. Acetyl group or acyl group, that are same. Acetyl group or acyl group. Remember that CH3CO group is called as the acyl or acetyl group, that is introduced into the benzene ring in place of the hydrogen atom of the benzene. Now acetylation is always done by two different reagents. One is the acetyl chloride and another is the acetic anhydride. Now what have acetyl group into that? Now this acetyl chloride is very simple, CH3COCl. Now when this acetyl group introduced into this carbon atom, the benzene ring, what happened? This hydrogen and this chlorine form the byproduct HCl, and there is formation of acetophenone. Why the name is acetophenone? See here, ONE is there as the suffix, that means it is ketone. You know that in ketone there is the CO group and two different alkyl or aryl group. Now this is the benzene, this is the methyl group, and into that there is the ketonic group. So the ONE suffix. Now why it is called as acetophenone? Because this is aceto group and this is phenyl group, and it is the ketone, so ONE is the suffix there. But in IUPAC name it is called as the 1-phenyl ethanol. Ethanol means 2 carbon atoms, so it is ethanol, and this is the phenyl ring. If hydrogen is replaced, benzene ring is called as the phenyl ring. So that, and one, this is the one position, 1, 2, 3, 4 in this way. So it is the 1-phenyl ethanol. Now see this another reagent that is really important, how it is obtained, that is the acetic anhydride. Now see here, give attention here, if we take two acetic acid molecule, now this is CH3COOH, you can write in this way, CH3COOH, now this is acetic acid, this is the acetic acid. Now take another acetic acid molecule, CH3COOH, and only replace or remove water molecule, H2O, into that. Anhydra means removal of hydra. Hydra means water. Here water get removed. H, this and this OH. What is remaining? CH3CO. CH3CO and this extra oxygen is there. So see this. CH3CO twice and this extra oxygen. Now this is converted into CH3CO twice O, and as water is removed from the two molecules of acetic acid, it is called as the acetic anhydride. Remember that. How this acetic anhydride is formed, that is very important first. And this acetic anhydride then reacts with that of the benzene ring. And what happened? The hydrogen atoms of this here is replaced by only one of these aceto group, CH3CO. One group remains as it is because there are two. Now that one group which is remaining and the extra oxygen, this is also there, and the replaced hydrogen from this is there. Now it formed the acetic acid as the byproduct, CH3COH. Remember that. When we use acetic anhydride, byproduct is acetic acid. And when we use acetyl chloride, byproduct is HCl. So which question they ask you in the examination? What is the action of acetic anhydride on benzene? Or what is the action of acetyl chloride on benzene? That depends your reaction. You write which reaction, and you will get full 2 marks if you give the well-balanced chemical reaction with nomenclature, with name, and with the byproduct, and which are the reagent written on the arrow. That is also important. Now let us see the last reaction of the benzene, that is the combustion of benzene. What is mean by combustion? Jvalan, burning. Combustion means burning. Which gas required for burning? Oxygen gas. For combustion, combustion means burning, and for burning we require the oxygen gas from the air. Now I write here 15/2 O2 molecule. What? Let us see here. Now 15/2 O2 means this two and these two get cancelled, only 15 oxygen atoms are required there. Only 15 oxygen. Why 15? Let us see. Now there are the 6 carbon and 6 hydrogen. You know that in benzene this is nothing but this is benzene. Remember that, okay? I write here only the molecular formula, not the structure. Now this 6 carbon converted into 6 carbon dioxide. I already tell you the organic compounds or any that is the carbon compound, if get burns, that converted into only 2 that is the products. One is carbon dioxide, another is the water vapor. Now 6 molecule of CO2 is formed, and there are 6 hydrogen atom. So definitely 3 molecules, 3 multiplied by 2, 6, 3 water molecules. Now see here how many oxygen they require. You only write first O2 and then think how many oxygen atoms are required. Now 6 multiplied by 2, 12, and plus 3 is 15. So we cannot write in this way 15O, That is not correct. We must write O as though in the molecular form O2. Then what will we do? Only take 15/2 O2 molecule. That means 2 to get cancelled, only 15 atoms will be remainder. And this is the combustion. So after combustion of benzene, we get the two different products. That is water and carbon dioxide. They may be a short note, or they may be asked this reaction also vary. If these are the chemical reactions of benzene. Now let us see the next topic. Into that we have to study. That is about the structure of benzene. We will see in the next lecture. Thank you.